Welcome to Fountain of Life Church London Thursday prayer meeting. As you join in, I just want you to connect to the presence of God and just invite the Holy Spirit into your space. Presence of God as you log in.
You alone deserve my worship.
In the midst of everything, He still deserves our worship. He still deserves our praises.
You alone deserve the honor.
And we will continue to lift the name of God high. In the midst of the trials and the tribulations, we will continue to lift the name of God high. Just connect to the presence of God as you log in. We lift you high, O God. Lift you higher than everything that is going on around us, God. We lift you high, O God. We lift you high. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Just begin to sing your own worship song to the Lord right now. Just begin to pour out everything, your worries, your thoughts. Whatever you're feeling, just begin to pour it out to the Lord right now. Yes, He is the great and mighty deliverer. And as He has done it before, we would watch and witness as He does it again. Concerning Nigeria, concerning COVID, His name will be the one that will be lifted the highest. We lift you high, O God. We lift you high, O God. Just begin to speak to your Father. He is our Father. He is our Shepherd. He is the one that knows us the deepest. He is closer to us than anyone. Just begin to speak to your Father right now. Yes, God, we lift you high. We lift you high. You are Adonai, O God. Your name will be lifted high. Above all names, above all things, O God, we will lift your name high and continue to lift your name high. Nothing that we will experience or go through would lead to us retracting or saying that you are still not the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, because your name is reigning supreme in the name of Jesus. Just begin to worship God in your own way. Just begin to speak to the King of Kings. Just begin to speak to your Father. Oh, what a privilege that we can go directly to God. We can speak directly to Him. Oh, Daddy Abbas, yes, oh God. We acknowledge you. You're all powerful, oh God. Nothing is impossible for you, oh God. There is nothing impossible, oh God. The one thing you cannot do is that you cannot fail. You have never failed and you will not start today. Come on, just lift up the name of Jesus. We lift you high, oh God. We lift you high, oh God. We lift you high, oh God. Yes, we lift you high, oh God, above our issues and problems, above what we are witnessing that is happening in our country, Nigeria. We lift up the name of Jesus. We lift up the name of Jesus. You will be victorious. Yes, 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 yes. We lift up the name of Jesus. We lift up the name of Jesus. Connect with God in your own way. Connect with God in your own way. Your name is above all names. Every knee shall bow, every tongue will confess that you are God, oh God. Even in this current situation, this current climate, you remain God. You remain God. Come on, just begin to sing the sweet, sweet song unto the Lord. Even as you, even in your sorrows, even with whatever that you are feeling, even with the burning or distress you might be feeling for Nigeria, just begin to sing to God right now. Just begin to focus on Jesus. Focus on Jesus. Focus on Jesus. He is still God. He is still God. Yes, he's Yahweh. Yes, he's Yahweh. Yes, he's Yahweh. Come on, let everything that has breath say the name of Jesus. Let everything that has breath praise the name of God. He is Yahweh. He is Yahweh. Despite what is going on around us, he remains God. He remains our sovereign God. He remains all powerful. Come on, lift the name of Jesus where you are. Lift the name of Jesus where you are. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, we commit this time of prayer to you. Your word says where two or three are gathered, you are there. So there is no doubt in our minds that you are here today. You are here this evening. Father God, as we pray as a church and as a community, we pray that you will hear us, that you will turn to us with your eyes open and your ears open to hear the cries and the request of your children, oh God. We hold on to hope because we have you, because we know that even when we cannot see what is going on, that you continue to work. And so shall it be even in this situation in the name of Jesus. And as we pray, I want to pray Romans 8, 26 to 27 for anyone on this call who has they want to pray, but it's difficult. They're struggling because of everything that's going on. And I want to pray Romans 8 to say that in the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. So even for anyone on this call that is struggling, they don't even know where to start with everything that is going on. The Word of God says that even when we do not know what we ought to pray, the Spirit Himself will intercede on our behalf. And we pray, oh God, that as we pray today for anyone that is struggling to pray and connect to the Spirit of God in this moment, that the Spirit Himself will intercede on our behalf in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Welcome to Thursday prayer meeting. I must say, this has been, what a week it has been. A lot of us on this call, we are Nigerians, and for those that are not Nigerians, you must have heard what has been going on in the country. And just witnessing that and everything has really, been heavy. It's been heavy for a lot of us to watch and to see. And so this prayer today, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be praying specifically for Nigeria. We're going to be declaring what we would want and want to see in our country, Nigeria. And the word that we're going to hold on to as we begin to declare is 2 Corinthians 5 verse 7, which says that we live by faith and not by sight. And that's really important, because if we live by sight, especially now with everything that's going on, a lot of us, we will be in a different frame of mind, in a different state than we are now. But as Christians, we live by faith, because we know and we hold on and we are confident that God is moving and God is going to do a new and great thing in Nigeria in the name of Jesus. And you know, as we think about why it is important, even at this time, you know, there are so many ways that we can all get involved in this fight for a new Nigeria. But as Christians, it is really important that we use our words, because the Bible tells us that there is power in the tongue, there is power in our words. And if you look at Ephesians 6 from verses 10 to 18, when it talks about the armor of God, it tells us that the sword, our sword, is of the Spirit, which is the word of God. So our weapon is the word of God. And so we're going to use that weapon today to be moved and to declare by faith and not by sight. And just to stir us up before we begin to declare what we want to see in our country, Nigeria, I want to read Hebrews 4 verses 12. Just to stir us up in terms of why the word of God is our sword, why the word of God is our weapon. Hebrews 4 verses 12 says, "For the word of God is living and active and full of power." I'm going to say that again. It says, "The word of God is living and active and full of power, making it operative." So what does it mean to be operative? Is that the word of God making it function, it's functioning and it's full of effect, it has effect. So when we declare the word of God, the word says that the word of God is operative, it has effect, it's functioning, and it's energizing, and it's effective. It says the word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword, and it penetrates. See, I love that word penetrate, because when I read it, it struck me, because it made me realize that no matter what the opposition is, when we think about our country, Nigeria, when we think about what has gone on this year, there is nothing that the word of God cannot penetrate through. And once it penetrates through, the word is operative, is energizing, is effective. So it says it penetrates as far as the division of the soul and spirit. I'm reading from the Amplified Version. And in brackets, it says the completeness of a person, and of both joints and marrow, the deepest parts of our nature. So it says the word of God penetrates the completeness of who we are and the deepest parts of our nature. So there is nowhere, there is nothing that we would encounter or experience that the word of God cannot penetrate through. And it says when it penetrates, it's exposing and judging the very thoughts and intentions of the heart. And so this is the power underneath the word of God. This power is active, it is living, it is full of power. Makes it operative, it's energizing, it's effective, it penetrates. And with that understanding, we're going to declare over Nigeria today. We're going to do a declarative prayer where we're going to speak into the country Nigeria. We're going to speak what God has said about our nation. And in Jesus' name, as we speak, it will also witness these things come to pass in the name of Jesus. So the chapter we're going to focus on today as a guide, just to guide us as we declare and speak into our country, Nigeria, is Isaiah 62. I'm going to be reading from the easy to read version. We're going to declare the chapter Isaiah 62 onto our nation, Nigeria. We're going to start from verse 1. So where it says Zion and Jerusalem, I'm going to take that out and I'm going to put Nigeria in there. It says, "I love Nigeria, so I will continue to speak for her. I love Nigeria, so I will not stop speaking. I will speak until goodness shines like a bright light, until salvation burns bright like a flame. See, because there is power in the tongue. See, when we're going through distress and tribulation, oppression, one of the first things that the devil tries to attack is our ability to speak into existence what we want happen. Because sometimes we might be distracted by sight. But because as Christians, we hold on to faith, one thing we're not going to stop doing is we're not going to stop speaking into Nigeria. And so we declare today that we will continue to speak into Nigeria until goodness shines like a bright light, until salvation burns like a flame in the name of Jesus. Now we're going to chapter 2 and we're going to declare this together. As we speak into Nigeria, all nations will see her goodness in the name of Jesus. I want you to say that with me. As we speak into Nigeria, one of the things we're speaking to Nigeria today is that all nations will see her goodness. All kings will see her honor. Then we will have a new name. Nigeria will have a new name that the Lord himself will give to us. Begin to declare that this evening, that in the name of Jesus, Nigeria will have a new name. And this new name is one that the Lord himself will give to us. And all nations will see our goodness. At the moment, all nations are seeing the killings, but by faith, we declare and we speak into Nigeria that in the name of Jesus, all nations will see her goodness and all kings will see her honor. Begin to declare that in the name of Jesus, God will give Nigeria a new name, one that he himself will give to us, one that he himself will pick for us in the name of Jesus. I want you to declare that because we have read that there is power in our words. The word of God, when we speak the word of God, the word of God is active, it is effective, it is moving, it is penetrating. So declare that Nigeria will have a new name in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare that. A name that God himself will give to us. A name that God himself will give to us. At the moment, the news coming out of Nigeria is news of loss and death and havoc. But in the name of Jesus, that God is going to turn that around, and the news that is going to come out of Nigeria is going to be one of goodness, one of honor in the name of Jesus. Come on, begin to declare that. Declare that with confidence. You're not just saying this for the sake of saying this. You're saying this because as a child of God, there is power in your words, and you're using your words as a weapon in the name of Jesus. Let's go to verse 3. Verse 3 says, Nigeria will be like a beautiful crown, hallelujah, that the Lord holds up, like a king's crown in the hand of our God. Now begin to declare that in the name of Jesus, God will pick up Nigeria like a beautiful crown and hold us up like a king's crown in the hands of God. Begin to declare that God is going to turn his eyes and ears towards Nigeria. God is going to turn his face towards Nigeria. God is paying attention to Nigeria, and surely he will pick us up like a beautiful crown and hold us up in the name of Jesus. Come on, begin to declare that. Today we are doing declarative prayers. We are declaring and speaking into existence what we want for our country. It doesn't matter if you are in the UK or if you're in America or if you are in Canada. See, you were born Nigerian for a reason, and at this point we're going to declare into our country the Lord will pick us up like a beautiful crown and hold us up in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare that this evening. Begin to declare that this evening. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. The Lord will pick us up like a beautiful crown and hold us up like a king's crown in the hand, in his hands. In the name of Jesus. Verse 4 says, Nigeria will never again be called the people God left. Hallelujah. Our land will never again be called the land God destroyed. People will see our land and they will call it the people God loves. People will see Nigeria and they will call it the people God loves. Our land will be called God's bride because the Lord loves us. In the name of Jesus, begin to declare that. Never again will people look at Nigeria and say that this is the country and it holds the people that God left, or it is the land that God destroys. Never again will people look at Nigeria and say that this is the country that God has forsaken us, or God is not with us. That is not true. From this moment forward, people will see our land and they would say that these are the people that God loves. Nigerians, these are the people that God loves. And Nigeria is God's bride because God loves us. Begin to declare. Never again will people look at Nigerians and say, these are the people God left. Or look at our land and say, this is the land that God destroyed. No, because that is not what God has spoken for our country. When people see our land, they will say, these are the people that God loves. And when people see Nigeria, they will say, this is God's bride because God loves our nation. Begin to declare that. Never again, because God's hand is in Nigeria. God has not forsaken us. He will never leave us. He will never forsake us. We are the people that God loves. We are a nation that will be called God's bride because He loves us. Never again will they see us and say, Nigerians are the people that God left. Never. Never again will they look at our land and say, this is the land that God destroyed because of wickedness. Never, because God will have mercy. Begin to declare mercy over Nigeria. Begin to declare, say, God, have mercy over Nigeria. God, have mercy over Nigeria. We will be a people that you love. We will be a nation that will be called God's bride because you love us. Begin to declare that right now in the name of Jesus. See, because we are moved by faith and not by sight, despite everything that has happened this week, we hold on to the confidence. We hold on to faith that God is moving. God is continuously moving. And because of that, we are declaring this evening what is going to happen in Nigeria in the name of Jesus. The Bible says that what we bind on earth is bound and what we loose is loose, both in heaven and on earth. So we take that authority and we begin to declare our country is not going to be one that say, God, they have been forsaken by God. Our country is not going to be one where they'll say, God left them. No. God loves us. God's hand is upon us. God is going to hold us up like a beautiful crown in the name of Jesus. We will be known as the people that God loves. We'll be known as the country that is God's bride in the name of Jesus. Chapter 5 says, I'm reading from the Amplified Version. As a young man takes a bride and she belongs to him, so our land will belong to our children. As a man is happy with his new wife, so God will be happy with us. See, in the name of Jesus, all the narratives and the stories that we hold right now about Nigeria, one that we say, what are we living for our children and the next generation? The word of God is saying, from this day forward, our land is going to be one that belongs to our children. We are leaving something valuable behind. That is the Nigeria. This is the new Nigeria, the new song we're going to sing about Nigeria in the name of Jesus. And as a man is happy with his wife, God will look upon Nigeria and he will be happy with our country. He will be happy with our leaders. He'll be happy with the things that are going on in our country. That is the new Nigeria that we are stepping into. Begin to declare that in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare that in the name of Jesus. And if you are as you're declaring, some thoughts are coming in and some doubt is seeping in and you're saying, I am tired. This has been going on for so long. Remind yourself that we are moved by faith and not by sight. See, as Christians, yes, we can acknowledge that we are tired, but then we remember that God's strength is made bigger and richer in our weakness. And so we rely on God's strength in this moment and we declare that we are building with everything that is happening. What is going to be birthed out of this is a nation that we can leave for our children. With everything that is happening, what is going to be birthed out of this is a nation that would make God happy, that will be pleasing in the sight of God. Begin to declare. I want you to declare. I want you to speak with boldness. You have to understand that the word of God is life. The word of God penetrates. The word of God moves. So you need to declare because your words has action. See, we know that we can act behaviorally, but as Christians, our word also moves. It changes things because we are speaking the word of God. So I want you to declare it and mean it because you are changing things. We are changing things in the spiritual realms, and we will witness the manifestation of that in the physical realm in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Verse 6 says, Nigeria, I put guards on your walls. They will not be silent. They will keep praying day and night. Guards, keep praying to the Lord. Remind him of his promise. Don't ever stop praying. I want to use this verse to encourage us. See, as Christians, we are automatically guards on the wall. And we know that, see, our God, Jesus has told us that there is power in persistent prayer. That when we continue to knock on God's door, God will open. The Bible says that when we ask, he answers. And the chapter 6 says that pray, remind God of his promise, and don't ever stop praying. Right now, whatever personal word God has given you for Nigeria, whatever thing that you are holding on to when you think about our country, Nigeria, this is the time to begin to pray that, because the word of God says, remind God of his promise. Don't stop praying. Be encouraged. Your words, your prayers are doing something. Your prayers are beneficial. Your prayers are, God is listening to the prayers of his people. We are watchguards. Don't stop praying. Begin to declare the promises that God has given you over Nigeria. Remind God of his promises. As I say this, I'm reminded of Isaiah 60. Nigeria will arise. Nigeria will shine. For the light of God has come. Nigeria will arise. Nigeria will shine. For God's light has come. Begin to declare right now the promises God has given you. See, when you pray, you are knocking on God's door. And as a child of God, when you knock on God's door, do you know what he does? He looks and he listens. Be encouraged. Don't stop praying. As the song says, even when I don't see it, he's working. Even when I cannot feel it, he's moving. And that is the case today, and that is the case for Nigeria, and that is the case for any personal trial or tribulation we are going through. Do not lose hope. Do not lose faith. Stand on God's word. Stand on his confidence. He is working. Continue to pray. Continue to pray. And when the words are not coming out, please remember Romans 8, 26 to 27, and begin to pray that even in our weakness, the Holy Spirit will intercede on your behalf, because he knows the things that are deep in your heart that you cannot utter. So don't stop praying. Be encouraged this evening. God is about to do a new thing in Nigeria. What we are seeing, we're not going to be moved by it, because we're not moved by sight, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Verse 7, we're reading from Isaiah 62. If you're just joining us, we're now in verse 7. It says, don't give him any rest until he rebuilds Jerusalem. I love that. Don't give God any rest. God never sleeps or slumbers anyway. But it says, don't give God any rest until he builds Jerusalem and he makes it a place that everyone on earth will praise. See, this is the time for persistent prayer. Continue to pray. See, God is listening to the cries of his people. He himself, he directs us. He says, be anxious for nothing, but with prayer and supplications, make your request known to God. He tells us to bring it to him. He says, bring it to me. Anything that you are burdened about, anything that you are anxious about, anything that you are doubting, you're saying, God, this situation, is it like this? What will happen? He instructs us to bring that to him. And so there is power in persistent prayer. Don't stop praying. Your prayers do not fall on deaf ears. God is listening. God is moving in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare. Begin to declare in the name of Jesus. Verse 8 says, the Lord made a promise and guaranteed it by his own power. And he will use that power to keep his promise. The Lord said, I promise that I will never again give your food to your enemies. I promise that they will never again take the wine you make. And this is the promise we receive, and we declare this promise for Nigeria. You see, when I read that, what I thought about, you see, right now, a lot of us, we are fighting with all the energy we have for a better Nigeria. And I felt like God was saying that everything that we have put into, you know, Nigeria is infamous for you put into the country, you give, you see no results, or something will happen, the government will do something, will disappoint you. And verse 9 says, never again, whatever you sow into the country, whatever you put into the country, God says that you will reap that. You begin to see produce as Nigeria. Nigerians begin to see produce and fruitfulness in our country in the name of Jesus. People will no longer come and eat the food that we have sown. People never again will take the wine that we have sown in our country in the name of Jesus. We'll begin to see and witness and experience fruitfulness coming from our country, Nigeria, in the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter if you're in the UK or you're in America, you will also witness and be part of that fruitfulness because we are connected as a nation, as a people, and so shall it be in the name of Jesus. As God has promised and guaranteed by his own power, he will use that power to keep his promise. So please never doubt God. If God has said it, he will finish it. I remember I was on one prayer the other day, and I think it was Pastor Bisoye that said, God is the Alpha and Omega. So he never starts something if he's not going to end it. If he starts something, he will finish it. And the word of God also tells us that anything he starts, he will finish it and he will work it together for our good. So any doubt that we have right now, we just begin to declare, say, there's no doubt here, because God, as he has declared a promise, he will use that same power to keep his promise. It doesn't involve us. We don't have to do anything about that. All we have to do is continue to stand on his word and pray. And God, as he promised, will complete that promise in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Verse 10 says, come through the gates, clear the way for the people, prepare the road, move all the stones off the road, raise a flag as a sign for the nation. Verse 11 says, listen, the Lord is speaking to all the far away lands. Tell the people of Nigeria, look, your Savior is coming. Hallelujah. He's bringing your reward to you. He's bringing it with him. See, clear, say, come through the gates, clear the way for the people, prepare the road. See, right now with everything that's going on, we might feel discouraged, but the word of God is saying, this is the time to begin to prepare. This is the time to begin to make room. This is the time to begin to move the stones off the road. This is the time to begin to raise a flag as a sign for the nation, because the Lord is coming. The Lord is coming. It says, tell everybody from the faraway lands, tell the people of Nigeria. So that is us included. Our Savior is coming, and he's bringing our reward to us. He's bringing it with him. Hallelujah. That is going to be our testimony in the name of Jesus. God is moving. God is coming, and he's coming with our reward. He's bringing it to us in the name of Jesus. So it's time for us to clear the roads. It's time for us to come through the gates. It's time for us to start rejoicing. See, it's one of the hardest things to do in the midst of oppression and in the midst of tribulation is to praise. But we're not praising because we are unaware of what we're going through. We're praising because we are aware of what God is about to do. Our God is coming. Our God is showing up for Nigeria. He has shown up for Nigeria thus far, and he will not stop continuing to show up for Nigeria in the name of Jesus. Begin to take comfort in that word. Begin to praise him for that word, that he is coming. He is coming with our reward. He is coming to do a new thing. He's coming to reshape and make a new Nigeria in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare that in the name of Jesus. We thank you, O God. We thank you because we put our trust in you. And because of that, we know that you are doing a good thing. We will sing a new song when it comes to our country, Nigeria. This year has been tough, but we hold on to you because we know that even when we're going through things, it says count it all joy when you're going through difficulties, because our faith is being stressed, and we will see the glory of God in Nigeria in the name of Jesus. We will see the glory of God in the name of Jesus. And I like that prayer point. Lord, sustain the youth in the name of Jesus. People in the forefront that are moving and are leading this change. We pray, pray, oh God, that you will keep them, that you uphold them, that you will protect them in the name of Jesus. We also pray for every person that has lost a loved one or a family member during this time, oh God. We pray for peace, peace that surpasses all understanding, peace for their minds, peace for their hearts, in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare, God is about to do a new thing. God is about to do a new thing. He is coming. So clear the gates, clear the way, prepare the roads. Listen, the Lord is speaking. God is speaking to us. He says to all the faraway lands, tell the people of Nigeria, look, your Savior is coming. He's bringing your reward to you. He's bringing it with him in the name of Jesus. And the last verse says, Nigeria, his people, we are his people. So we as Nigerians will be called the holy people, the saved people of the Lord. And you, Nigeria, will be called the city God wants, the city God is with. So shall it be in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare that. We as Nigerians will be called the holy people. We will be called the saved people of the Lord. As we start calling ourselves that today, the saved people of the Lord. See, it's saved as in past tense, meaning that God has already done the saving. So we are just, well, we have just not caught up to it in the physical realm. But in the spiritual realm, God has already done the saving. We shall be known as the saved people of the Lord in the name of Jesus. And our country, Nigeria, will be known as the city God wants, the city God is with, in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare that Nigeria would be known as the city God wants, the city God is with, in the name of Jesus. Declare, say, Nigeria, you will be known as the city God wants. Nigeria, you will be known as the city God is with. We pray that the presence of God will cover the whole of Nigeria, that anything that is contrary to the word of God will stand still, will have no authority or dominion. We pray that God's will stand forth and triumph in the name of Jesus. And pray as well and declare, say, Nigerians, I as a Nigerian, Nigerians and citizens of Nigeria, we will be known as the holy people in the name of Jesus. We will be known as the people that God saved in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare that we are the people that God has saved. We are the holy people, and our country, Nigeria, is the city that God wants. Isn't God merciful? I think that phrase there really signifies the mercy of God, that Nigeria will be the city that God wants. Despite everything that has happened, despite the all the different things that are happening in Nigeria that is contrary to God, God is letting us know that his mercy is forevermore. And despite that, his mercy reigns. And because of that, he will still look at our country, Nigeria, and say, you, Nigeria, you are a city that I want in the name of Jesus. And he says that is a city that God is with. Oh, Father God, we thank you. This Nigeria will be a city that God is with. And as I said that, what I was reminded of, Holy Spirit, help me, I think it's the word Jehovah Nisi. And please correct me if I'm wrong. Jehovah Nisi means God is our banner, God our banner. And when I was reading that, I was reading about the people of the Israelites, and how every battle they fought, they didn't fight it strategically with their own wisdom and with their own human power. Every battle they fought and they won, it was through the will of God. And it was because of spiritual favor. And everybody knew that God was with the Israelites. And so if you think about the wall of Jericho, they were scared, not because they didn't have the tools to fight the Israelites, but they were scared because of who was backing them. And that was the presence of God. And Jehovah Nisi, that we raise the, God is our banner, because everything that happens, we know that God is here and it is God that is doing those things. And so to hear and to declare in verse 12 that the city of God, that Nigeria will be known as the city God is with, is a confirmation for me that we will come to know in Nigeria, we'll come to know God as Jehovah Nissi, God our banner, because God is going to fight our battles. We do not have to fight those battles because God is going to fight our battles. Things that seem impossible become possible for Nigeria in the name of Jesus, and we will be known as the holy people. Will be known as the people that God has saved. And as we have declared all these things this evening, declared praying Isaiah 62 over our country Nigeria and over every citizen of Nigeria, whether in the country or outside of the country, we pray that so shall it be in the name of Jesus. We will witness a new Nigeria. God will hold us as like a crown and lift us up in the name of Jesus. Good news. At the moment we are hearing bad news, but we'll begin to hear good news coming out of Nigeria in the name of Jesus. And as always, again, we declare peace to everyone that has lost a loved one during this time in the name of Jesus. Nigeria, you will be great. Nigeria, we will sing a new song. Nigeria, God has not forsaken you. We will be known as the country that God is with, and the people of Nigeria will be known as the country that God saved. That will be our testimony in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen and amen. Amen. I feel great. It's so freeing when you recognize that you don't have to fight any battle on your own. It's so freeing when you recognize that you have the all-powerful God standing beside you and is ready to fight your battles. And all we have to do is just to give it to Him. What a freeing and liberating thing to know and to stand on this evening in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And if praying from Isaiah 62 ministered to you, please do not just stop here. Anytime you think about Nigeria or you hear news from Nigeria, begin to declare Isaiah 62 over and over again over our country, Nigeria, in the name of Jesus. So we've come to the end of prayer today. Thank you all for joining in and praying together. As always, there is power in unity, and there is comfort in unity when we know that we are standing together and we are declaring and praying for a common cause. So thank you all for coming and joining this prayer today. As always, if you want to give into what God is doing in Fountain of Life London, give your offering, give your tithes, please do that through our account details. But if you're not a member of Fountain of Life London and you still want to give to what God is doing in the house, please DM us and somebody will get back to you with that information. Thank you for coming in today, and please remember that despite everything that is going on, we can see it. We are not denying that things are going on, but we are moved by faith and we stand on the word of God, and we are not moved by sight. We are moved by faith and we are not moved by sight. Thank you all. Have a lovely evening. And we'll see you on Saturday if you are a woman, and Sunday for Sunday service. Bye for now.